7 Habits of Highly Effective People is the most life-changing book I have ever read. If you ask any self-help guru, they will tell you that this book by Stephen Covey is among the top 5 self-improvement books of all time. Every single habit mentioned in this book is directly applicable to programmers. Yet I don't see anyone talking about it on YouTube. Today I want to show you how any programmer can apply these habits in their life and become a 10x programmer. Let's do this. According to Stephen Covey, there are 2 kinds of people in this world. First are the reactive kind. These people believe that their lives are shaped by forces that are beyond their control, such as other people's behavior, economy, or the weather. And then there are proactive people. They focus on things that are within their control. These people tend to take complete ownership of their actions and focus on what they can do to improve their situation. In the same way, there are 2 kinds of programmers. First are the reactive programmers. They believe that their career as a programmer can be built upon some life-changing video about how I learned programming in 4 months. Or someone will hand them a secret list of top 100 interview problems, and that's how they will crack coding interviews at big tech companies. Proactive programmers, on the other hand, know that all these things are good to know, but eventually it's them who's responsible for their own career. They understand that it takes years of practice to become a good programmer. They make mindful choices like reading documentation or building projects to hone their programming skills. They also spend a good amount of time learning the fundamentals of data structures and algorithms and practice a lot of interview-style problems. In other words, they look for inspiration within them rather than expecting someone else to deliver some magic potion to them. As the second habit, the author recommends beginning with the end in mind. Many people spend their entire life sleepwalking. They get so involved in their day-to-day life that they don't spend any time strategizing. Hope as your only strategy is not exactly a great way to succeed at anything. When strategizing, Stephen Covey recommends beginning with end in mind. In other words, before you start any project, you need to have clear vision of your ultimate goals. If you apply this to programming, whenever you take on a new project, you need to spend some time to understand the end product. What are the functional requirements of the features you are building? In other words, how should the system work? And what are some non-functional requirements? In other words, how should the system perform? Software engineering is the art of making trade-offs. It's rare to have one right solution. So list out the different design choices and write their pros and cons. Make the final choice only after you have carefully analyzed the trade-offs of different options. 30 minutes of planning can easily save you 30 hours in programming. Now that you have planned everything, we need to put first things first. In other words, highly effective people always prioritize. The book recommends using Eisenhower Matrix for prioritization. The Eisenhower Matrix categorizes tasks into 4 quadrants depending on urgency and importance. On the bottom right, we have tasks that are neither important nor urgent. We simply eliminate these tasks. On the bottom left, there are urgent tasks that are not important. Find someone who can do these tasks for you. On the top left, we have tasks that are urgent as well as important. You need to do these tasks right away. On the top right, we have tasks that are not urgent but important. Schedule a time to do these tasks. It's the tasks in this quadrant that most programmers overlook. When you work as a software engineer, you're constantly bombarded by the bugs that you need to resolve. You also have ongoing long-term projects to take care of. When you have so much pressure, learning starts taking a backseat. If your code is throwing an error, you just want to Google and copy-paste the first solution without really understanding it. Truly understanding the cause of the issue is important for learning, but not urgent. But it's very hard to make time for it, so it often gets overlooked. That's why for many engineers, the learning stops as they progress in their careers. So you need to keep an eye out for tasks that fall in this quadrant and schedule a dedicated time for them for your long-term success. One person's gain is another's loss. This idea is so ingrained in our brains, maybe because of all the sports we watch. But life is not a zero-sum game. In the book, Dr. Covey emphasizes the importance of developing an abundance mentality. That is, believing that there are enough resources and opportunities for everyone to succeed. And this mindset is very important to have a successful career as a software engineer. Software engineers constantly work alongside other engineers and people in other job functions like data scientists and product managers. Being able to collaborate with them effectively is one of the top skills an engineer needs to have. So it's essential to be able to rise above your personal career goals and have a win-win mindset for the team. It's highly likely that if the team wins, you will also win. This also applies to getting promoted at work. Instead of competing with a colleague for promotion, you can collaborate on a project that shows both of your strengths, leading to recognition and advancement for both. Are you the kind of person who's busy thinking about your response long before the other person has finished talking? Stephen Covey recommends not doing exactly that. He recommends immersing ourselves in others' perspectives before sharing our own. By understanding others first, we can tailor our message to resonate with their wavelength, transforming communication into a meaningful dialogue. But how does that apply to programmers? In addition to verbal communication, programmers also use their code to communicate with each other. Effective programmers understand the importance of empathy in coding. They prioritize clarity in their code to ensure that others, including their future self, can understand and maintain it easily. In addition to other engineers, programmers also communicate with end users through their products. Effective programmers prioritize user experience by putting themselves in the shoes of the end users. They anticipate user needs, design intuitive interfaces, and create error messages that guide users instead of confusing them. Together, we can create better solutions than any of us can alone. That's the basic essence of synergy. Mathematically, 1 plus 1 is always equal to 2. But in life, if you have the right synergies, 1 plus 1 can be equal to 11. In the sixth habit, Dr. Kavi talks about the importance of valuing differences between people and using those disparities to create a whole that is greater than the sum of its parts. Synergy in programming is about leveraging the strengths of each team member to create products that the users love. Effective programmers embrace collaborative coding practices like code reviews, pair programming, or knowledge sharing. By combining individual expertise and insights, teams can build products that are more robust, efficient, and innovative. For programmers, this is the most important habit of all. To understand this habit, let me ask you a question. Imagine that there are two workers who are trying to cut some wood. First worker is a young guy who goes on cutting wood for entire 8-hour shift. Second worker, who's an older gentleman, needs breaks. During his 10-minute break every hour, he spends 5 minutes sharpening his saw. Who do you think will cut more wood at the end of the shift? If you can see that it's the older gentleman who will cut more wood, you have understood the seventh habit. With so many new technologies coming out every year, effective programmers understand the importance of sharpening their saw. Sharpening the saw involves investing time in acquiring new skills, staying updated on industry trends, and exploring emerging technologies. Effective programmers dedicate time for professional development by attending conferences, participating in coding communities, and seeking feedback on their work. This habit ensures that they remain at the forefront of technological advancements and become future-proof. Another book that can be very useful for programmers is Atomic Habits by James Clear. This book is especially important for those who struggle to build the habit of programming consistently. If you want to know how to apply Atomic Habits in your life, watch this video. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.